Hello and welcome to the 17th video of my Left 4 Dead 2 mapping tutorial series. Today is the day that we'll finally publish our map onto the Steam Workshop for the world to try out. In this video, we'll be going over creating the Addoninfo.txt file, packaging the map into a VPK, and uploading it with the Workshop Manager and Left 4 Dead 2 authoring tools. Firstly, let's get all the assets, scripts, maps, etc. compiled into one folder. Make a folder somewhere on your PC and title it. I'll be referring to this folder from now on as the mod folder. Next, grab any and all of your custom assets, that being materials, models, and sounds, and paste them into this mod folder. In part 15 of the series, we created a game folder in Left 4 Dead 2 dedicated to holding all of our custom assets, and this is why. We can easily take everything in here and paste them into the mod folder. Done. If you've put all your custom assets in the default Left 4 Dead 2 game folder, then you'd have a hard time remembering what you've made and where they're located. Next, let's get the maps that are included in the mod. In the root folder of the mod folder, make a new folder called Maps. Open the Left 4 Dead 2 game folder and open the Maps folder. Select all the maps and their .nav files, copy them, and paste them into the mod's map folder. If you've made any custom sound scripts or particles, be sure to take those text files as well and put them in the map folder. Now, we have to grab the mission file we made in the last video. Go back to the Left 4 Dead 2 game folder and open up the missions folder. Make a new folder inside of here called Inactive. Move the mission folder to this folder. What this does is disable the mission file from working in game. We need to do this so that when we package the mod and test it out, it doesn't conflict with this mission file that's already in the game files. Copy the mission file. In your mod folder, make a new folder called Missions and paste the mission file inside of it. Last thing we'll be grabbing are all of the custom V scripts that you've made for your mod. In your mod folder, make a new folder called Scripts and open it. Make a new folder in here called vscripts. Go back to the Left 4 Dead 2 game folder and open up the scripts folder. If you've made any custom melee weapons, soundscapes, or population files, grab them and port them over to the mod script folder. I haven't covered any of these in the series so far, so there's a likely chance you haven't made any of them, so just ignore what I just said. Chances are if you followed my tutorial series then you've made your own vscript. Open up the vscripts folder and copy and paste any vscripts that you've made into the mod's vscripts folder. We've ported over everything to the mod. Last thing we need to make before packaging is the addoninfo.txt file and an image to represent your mod in the add-ons folder in game. In the root of the mod folder, create a new text file and name it addoninfo.txt. In the description is a link to the Valve Developer Community Wiki page going over the addoninfo.txt file. Scroll down the page and look for generic addoninfo.txt. Select everything inside of the example, copy, and paste it into our own addoninfo.txt. This is similar to a mission file, but a lot shorter. First, the add-on Steam app ID. If you're making a Left 4 Dead 2 mod, leave it unchanged. Next, the add-on title is obvious. This is the title of the mod, or add-on, that will show in game. Name it whatever you want, 20 characters max. Add-on version is obvious, it's the version of the add-on. Unlike the mission file, this value can include decimals. The add-on author is you. Add-on description is again obvious. Write a short and concise description of the mod. After that is a set of options that indicate what the add-on consists of. They're all explained in the comments on the right. Set the option to 1 if your mod contains the respective content. For example, my mod has vscripts and sounds, so I'll set add-on content underscore script and add-on content underscore sound to 1. That's it with the addoninfo.txt file. Now we'll make an image to represent the mod. The size of the image doesn't matter. The resolution, however, should be in a 2:1 ratio. So something like 512 by 256 would work. When you have the image, save it as a JPEG. Next, open VTF Edit and import the image. Export the image as a JPEG, but name the image addonimage.jpg. According to the wiki, the image may not work if exported from certain programs, so we're exporting it from VTF Edit to be safe. Place the addonimage.jpg into the mod folder. We're finished with the mod folder. All that's left is to package it up into a VPK file and upload it to the workshop. Navigate to the Left 4 Dead 2 game files, and then open the bin folder. The Left 4 Dead 2 game files are different from the Left 4 Dead 2 game folder. Scroll and look for vpk.exe. Drag the whole mod folder onto the executable. In the same folder that contains the mod folder will be a packaged VPK of the mod. VPK files are what Left 4 Dead 2 uses for its add-on system. Before we publish it to the workshop or any other site, we should test it out first. Open the Left 4 Dead 2 game files, open the Left 4 Dead 2 game folder, and open the add-ons folder. Drag and drop the mod VPK into this folder and launch Left 4 Dead 2 to test it out. If everything looks good, if all your vscripts are working, if the mission file appears correct, if you could see the add-on image JPEG, then you're ready for publishing. Open Left 4 Dead 2 authoring tools and double-click on Workshop Manager. This is the application that is commonly used to upload mods to the workshop. Hit the plus sign on the top left to start publishing a new mod. Give the mod a title and a description. Choose an image to show up as the thumbnail in the workshop. The image has to be in a resolution of 640 by 360. Under File, click Browse and locate the VPK file for the mod that we dropped in the Left 4 Dead 2's add-ons folder. I recommend setting visibility to private for now, as we'll be editing the workshop page a little bit before we set the mod to public. Next, check any tags that are relevant to your mod. Accept the workshop's terms and conditions with the check mark at the bottom left and hit upload on the bottom right. It may take a good amount of time to upload depending on the file size of your mod, so just be patient. When it's done uploading, it'll try to open the workshop page for the mod in your web browser, but it will show up as an error because we set it to private. On the actual Steam client, navigate to Left 4 Dead 2's workshop and hover over the text that says Your Files, and click Files You've Posted. Open your mod's workshop page. If you want to edit the description or title, you could do so with the Edit Title and Description button. You can add more preview images by clicking the Add/Edit Images and Videos button. Upload as many images as you want, or even a YouTube video. When you're done with all your editing, you could change the visibility to public. That's it with publishing your mod. If you'd like to update the mod, you could return to the Workshop Manager program, double-click the existing mod, and select a newly updated VPK file for it to use. You can also change the thumbnail here if you wish, along with entering patch notes for the update. This concludes the 17th video of my Left 4 Dead 2 mapping tutorial series. It's been a long and wild ride. In the next video, I'll be going over how to make a survival map. Those are simple, so it won't take long. Thank you for watching.